Evidently, 11.4 is the number. What is that the number for? And if you think about the children's message, any guesses? 11.4. Yes, the number of times an average American will move in their lifespan. Supposedly now it's 11.4 times. That's a lot of moving. That's a lot of leaving along the way. And of course, in the message, though, we hear at the title, leaving one place means going to another. And it may seem kind of simple, well, duh, of course it means going to another. But really, emotionally for us, often we don't necessarily remember that. And it makes sense if you think about it, because when you leave, when there's any kind of ending, you think about all the places that you know, all the people that you know. You think of all that's coming to an end, and the next part coming forward is still an unknown. So it makes sense when we leave, there's sometimes also a time to grieve as we leave, whether it's for a loss of a loved one or really any kind of leaving, because we're leaving all the people and places and things that we know, and we just don't know what's going to happen next. But as we heard in the children's message, God will be with us no matter where we go. And of course, it is true that leaving one place means being able to go to another. So there is always new life and new beginning on the other side. We've had some moves too, haven't we, Dina? One of the moves we considered was a dream move to Oregon. After we had honeymooned and gone across the country and up into Canada, and we fell in love with the Pacific Northwest and always wanted to go back. And it was a few years later, and Dina had had that tragic car accident where we were wondering if she might even survive at first. And of course, having recovered from that, but being young adults together, still fairly newly married without kids yet, we had a different sense after that of what life was about and not feeling so Superman-ish anymore. And just being more aware that each moment and each day is precious. And no matter your health or anything else, it all can change in a heartbeat. So we started dreaming a little bit too. What do we want to do in this time that we have? Because we don't know how much time we do have. And we thought, well, maybe this is a good time to go out to that Northwest that we've dreamed about. No kids yet, parents were in good health, and we didn't know how long all that would stay the same. And when those things change, we might have thought, well, we wouldn't want to go then. So we were very nostalgic about Oregon and about the Northwest going back, but we didn't know, well, we were just there a short time. What would it be like actually living there? Would we be excited or disappointed? It was a great unknown. And of course, we would be leaving behind all of our family. We had no family even close to the Mississippi, much less west of it. And that's on both sides of our family. But we also finally decided, and in praying and discerning and talking with God about it, that if we didn't go, we would regret not going. And even if it were a lot worse than we thought it was, we thought we'd give it 2 or 3 years, and then we'd just come back here to home, come back to the South. And so we took off and went to Oregon, and it was actually better than we thought it was going to be. It was a wonderful dream move, and we stayed out there 8 years and had Brandon and Lauren there. They are native Oregonians, as you call it out there, both born in Portland. But then we started thinking way back, and we would see family now and then, they'd see us now and then, but 3,000 miles apart. Because we were only 60-some miles from the Pacific Ocean in Portland, so it was literally 3,000 miles apart. Maybe it was time to come back and be closer to family for the kids. Then we had to leave behind all the places and people that we'd come to love in Oregon. But leaving there meant coming back, going back to the South, and we came back to Roswell. And after a while, I got a call at Prince of Peace Lutheran Church, too. And then I stayed at home. Someone was a stay-at-home dad. We loved that, too, that time. And then finally, a call to Holy Trinity Lutheran Church here in Marietta. And leaving Oregon, which we loved so much, meant beautiful blessings of new life and new beginnings here, for which we were very grateful. But sometimes in the midst of the change and the transition, it's hard to see. And it's hard to have that full sense of hope and peace and comfort looking forward when it's total unknown in front of you. But maybe that's part of the gift that we can take with us also from that children's message of knowing that God is with us all along the way. And for everything that we leave, there are things to go to. And people, places, new beginnings, new life. Jesus also had to leave, as we heard about today in the gospel. I am telling you these things while I'm still with you, Jesus says. But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and will remind you of all that I've said to you, Jesus says. So see, there is purpose and value in Jesus leaving. And where does Jesus leave to? To be back with the Father at the right hand of the Father in heaven, where Jesus had been before coming to earth. It makes sense for Jesus to go. But it's hard for us to accept, well, how Jesus has to leave? What? But Jesus leaves to make space and presence for the Spirit to be with us, to continue to teach everything and remind us of everything about Jesus too. So we lose nothing with that in the end. We simply gain another beautiful facet of God here with us. Besides, eventually, all the hosts of heaven and angels, they'll be in the same boat we're in the second coming, because Jesus will be leaving to come back again for us all over again. There are so many transitions and changes and yet also new beginnings in this life. Jesus goes on to say, "Peace I leave with you." It's like he's saying goodbye, although he's not leaving yet, but he's leaving this. I do not give to you as the world does. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Do not let them be afraid. It's a saying of goodbye, this peace that he leaves with us. That's also what we hope for today and this weekend, that it be a weekend of peace and it be a weekend of remembering. We remember our Lord who has gone before us. We also remember all those veterans who have paid the ultimate price and gone before us. And sometimes pastors aren't sure just what to preach, if anything, in Memorial Day, and to make it spiritual for that. For me, it's very easy to put the two together, because you have these servicemen and women who have given the ultimate sacrifice for us, for our freedom, and for our very lives. And we have a Savior who went to the cross, who paid the ultimate sacrifice for us, for our freedom, freedom from sin, and for life, now and everlasting. And so I believe the sacrifice that our service men and women have made is literally a Christ-like sacrifice for freedom and for life. So it's easy for us, I think, to remember both together this weekend. I also remember a personal friend of mine too, John. He was a member of Prince of Peace when I was pastor there, and he is also a veteran, a Navy veteran from World War II, and in his 90s. And he's been a member of the Johns Creek Veterans Association the whole time. As a matter of fact, he was the one who got me to go from the very beginning and come and be the volunteer chaplain for them years ago when I was at Prince of Peace, and continued all along. And just this week, I went to see him as chaplain with one of the other veterans. He is in hospice care now at home. And standing of full stature, he would be just over 6 feet tall. And right now, he weighs probably 110 pounds. And we don't know how long he will be here with us before he too is leaving. But as we remember John, and as we remember all those who have gone before us here at Holy Trinity too, we also remember the good news in this day, that through Christ and through the cross, with every ending, there is a new beginning. And even with death itself, now death is not the end. It is just a door to new life again. So from the youngest of us children to the most senior sages of us here, We will have our times going forward yet of leaving. But for every single one of us, we will leave to go to a new place, a new beginning, and new life. So let us remember this day with honor. All those who have gone before us, both our servicemen and women, our members here, our family that we love and cherish so much who have gone before us, let us never forget and honor and give thanks for all the blessings that have been. And at the very same time, let us also look forward. Because with their leaving and with our leaving, whatever kind of leaving or change or transition that may be, God is with us in the midst of that. And every time that we leave, there is a place to go to. So let us look forward to that future with hope, with trust, and maybe even a spirit of adventure into this wild unknown of God's future. For every single one of us, God has planned new beginnings and new life in His name. Amen.